150年前，当马克吐温造访圣地时写道，那是个寸草不生的地方，一片寂静与凄凉。
He talks about up in the Jezreel Valley. He talks about how that you can travel in 10 miles in any direction and not see a single person. And so one of the towns that we did some photography was of a small town of Afula, which was really off the map as far as many Westerners are concerned. But it was established in the early 1900s. So 50-60 years after Mark Twain, there's a small Jewish settlement. Today it's a booming Israeli city that we've been able to match some side-by-side perfect photography with it.
道格·赫斯的新著作呈现了200张1880到1940年代以色列的照片，记录了惊喜的变化。
We have these old photos of Tel Aviv of less than 100 years ago, of shacks on sand dunes with camel caravans on the beach, and to compare it from the exact same angle today, it's just stunning.
这些画面见证着预言的实现。以西结书36章8节说，以色列山那，你必发枝条，为我的名以色列结果子，因为他们快要来到。
We think of prophecy being to kings or to people or nations, but he's prophesying to the land that when Israel returns as a nation, branches will put forth fruit, waste cities will be rebuilt, people and beasts will be multiplied on the land will be cultivated and sown. This land has been conquered, 15-20 different times. It never becomes a homeland for any other people group, and the land would never produce for any other people group. And Israel moves back in, and suddenly the vast desert wastelands are now producing flowers, they're producing fruit. And for many centuries, believers would read that and look at that as allegorical or spiritual, and we're finding today it's very literal. It's happening right now.
在以色列庆祝建国70周年的时节，欣赏这些新旧照片，目睹以色列在极短时间内发生的巨大变化。以色列的复兴无疑是这个世代最大的神迹之一。